All right. My watch says 7 o'clock. Are we ready? Welcome to the 60th commencement ceremony of Conestoga Valley High School. I'm Principal Mike Thornton. Welcome to all our parents, grandparents, family, friends, the many educators here, our support staff, our teachers, our administration, our school board, all assembled here once again in Calvary Church. Our hosts, once again, have provided us with all manner of support to celebrate our seniors' graduation from high school. We cannot thank them enough, but let's try. Let's have a big hand for Calvary Church. We gather tonight to honor the class of 2018, celebrate their successful completion of their high school program at Conestoga Valley. Our tradition is to honor these graduates with a high degree of dignity and respect, and to present a ceremony fitting for this great occasion. To help us in this endeavor, we ask the following. Please silence all cell phones or other devices and refrain from using them during the ceremony, except the cameras, of course. And please be careful trying to get a picture of your graduate and being in the way of some other folks. We ask you to be gracious in that. Please minimize leaving the sanctuary during speeches and the presentation of our special awards. And we do ask for special consideration as graduates' names are called and they walk across the stage. We want to maintain proper pacing of our event. We want all the graduates' names heard nice and clearly, and we don't want to promote contests for recognition or anything like that. So please cooperate with that. We know you're very proud of the graduates. We are too. And at the end of the ceremony, there's the special time for all of that cheering and special celebration. We've practiced it. We want the ceremony remembered for the graduates, nothing else. Our school photographer, Life Touch, they are on hand tonight taking all manner of pictures, but they will be taking pictures of our graduates as they receive their diploma. Seniors receive their order forms and brochures will be in the lobby area. Two final notes. After the ceremony, graduates will be moving to the fellowship hall. That's where they assembled this evening to pick up their final diplomas. That's right, they don't actually get the diploma up here. One final bit of accountability. But they will go to the fellowship hall and receive their diploma, and then they'll be able to meet you in the lobby and so forth. When you're leaving, we will have Manheim Township Police and other staff from Calvary helping with lanes and traffic. Please respect them and be careful as you leave. Our graduates will be entering from the sides in the balcony, down the side steps. They'll come around into the second aisles to their seats. We're ready. Enjoy the ceremony. Thank you.
All right. So, do you guys know that moment in class when the teacher calls on you and you have no clue what the answer to the question is? So your palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, and you end up just kind of mumbling something that you think might be right in response. In that moment, you lose yourself. Now, one time in my sophomore year, I answered a question very timidly, but instead of just kind of glossing over that fact, my teacher stopped the entire class, and he told me, "Well, does Nicole believe in Nicole?" Now, as a naturally shy person who had, one, just stopped the entire class, and two, been called out for not knowing what the heck she was talking about, my immediate instinct was to want to cry, because my answer to that question was, no way. Why would I believe in myself? Now, when I told him that, again, my teacher stopped, but this time he looked right at me, and he told me, "Well, that's a shame, because I do." So his statement, almost like a defibrillator sending me an electric shock, brought me back to a time when I was filled with so much self-confidence that I thought I was invincible. In elementary school, we were taught that we could do anything, and we truly believed it. You could be an astronaut or Spider-Man, and someone like me could even be president of the United States. The community rallied behind our every interest. But then something happened. We entered middle school with all of its inherent, let's say, awkwardness, and we started to doubt ourselves and our abilities. No longer those starry-eyed, super confident elementary students who thought they could conquer the world. All of us struggled and fell down at one time or another, even if for some of us it was hard to notice. But seemingly every single time, a community surrounded us, helping us get back up. Friends invited us over to binge watch Gossip Girl on Netflix. Teachers told us to keep going with every seemingly tedious assignment. And parents pulled us out of bed when we didn't think we could do it anymore. While it may be hard to realize, if we take a deep breath and we look back, we can see that during these challenging times we grew the most. We learned to love each other and admit that we were hurting. So then we entered high school, and we kind of got through the jitters of freshman year and are rebounding in hopes of getting to this very point tonight. And guess what? We all made it. So something must have changed. Well, certain people entered our lives. Our teachers, friends, family, friends' parents, boyfriends and girlfriends, the very people in our own CV community. And with this, they helped us remember the reasons why we should believe in ourselves. Does Nicole believe in Nicole? Now, the moment that this change occurs, and the reasons why are different for all of us, but the message is the same. The community around us has embraced our differences and created a place where our struggles only make us stronger. For the past 13 years, we have been surrounded by people who have encouraged us to find ourselves by getting involved with activities ranging from field hockey to orchestra to even mock trial if you're a legal nerd like me. Whatever piqued your interest. You might start to find your place and your influence in the world at any high school, but at CV, you are expected to. This is the difference in our community. One that doesn't try to make each other something that we are not, but instead helps us figure out who we are, equipping us to use our newly found place and identity to make the world around us better after we graduate. Now, right now, if I were asked if I believed in myself, I would pause for a second, not in panic, but to think about the community that has lifted me up, the community that has helped me find my place. And somewhere in there, I would say that Nicole does believe in Nicole. But I know that this is not just my story. So seniors, I ask you, does the class of 2018 believe in the class of 2018? Or more importantly, do you believe in yourselves? Think about it. Think about the community that has built you back up every time you fell down. Think about the stronger, more impassioned person that you have become because of it. Think about the unique role in society that you have only just begun to fill as a result of the confidence that you gained here at CV. After spending the past 13 years finding my place alongside you, seniors, I ask you, do you believe in yourselves? Because I believe in us, and my hope is that you do too. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Anna. And for those of you who know me, you know it's rare when I'm truly at a loss for words. I mean, really, I always have something to say about everything, which is literally why I'm here tonight. So, I want to begin with a story that requires some visualization on your part. All right, here we go. Imagine you're in a new place, somewhere you've never been before. You're surrounded by people, but something feels off. You don't understand what is happening. You can't understand what they're saying. You want to ask someone what is going on, tell them that you're confused, that you don't understand, but you can't. You're feeling discouraged, feeling frustrated, feeling helpless. You're feeling voiceless. For some of you, that might hit close to home. Maybe some of you here tonight arrived in our district and didn't speak the language. Even when you speak the language, it can be difficult to find your voice, especially in high school. I've been in a situation like that before. I was going to school in France, but I didn't speak French. Like, not at all. Good choice, right? And for months, every day in school and with my French family, I just felt confused and so frustrated, angry with myself that I was incapable of understanding, of comprehending what people were saying to me. So I went in search of my own voice. In my case, it was learning French, to be able to communicate, to be able to understand. But voice isn't just about the sounds that come from your mouth. It's about what you have to say. Conestoga Valley has fostered us in an environment that allowed us to find and use our voices. Maybe it meant advocating for yourself to get into a higher level class or to get into the CTC program you wanted. Maybe it meant standing up for a friend or even yourself when no one else would. CV has encouraged us to use our voices all along. In fact, just this year, the CV administration encouraged students to join in the national debate about school safety. This topic makes a lot of students and teachers and parents uneasy, myself included. I don't like the thought of not being safe at school. No one does. But instead of keeping that fear bottled inside and making it worse, we were asked to share our thoughts and concerns. Through forums, discussions, trainings, and even a walkout in protest of violence in schools, we as students were encouraged to speak up. That is not voicelessness. That is empowerment. Graduates, as we look toward the future, we must recognize that it's time to move on from CV, to move on from our peers and teachers and mentors. It's time to become independent. We're all going in very different directions that require different skills and abilities. Thank goodness mine doesn't require high-level calculus. Yikes. But one skill we can all use is the ability to effectively use our voices. Yes, you can and you should use your voice to make jokes and tell stories. But remember, your voice is influential. What you have to say matters. Whether that's something you're telling your friends and family, or what you say to your boss or your professor, One day, we'll even have to think about what we'll say to our kids, because they remember everything. Choose your words carefully. That can be tough to do when you're put on the spot, especially about a topic that you care about. I've loved hearing what you've had to say on the segment Controversial Conversations. We've heard opinions ranging from believing that social media can be good for society to advocating that a hot dog is definitely not a sandwich. Even if someone doesn't shove a microphone in your face, share what you think. Share your thoughts and opinions and ideas because they're more powerful than you can even imagine. Guys, people can learn from you. Your words can affect change. Madeleine Albright, a former Secretary of State, she's really cool, guys, trust me, said, "It took me quite a long time to develop a voice. And now that I have it, I am not going to be silent." So, class of 2018, speak up, because we want to hear what you have to say. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. The class of 2018 is a remarkable group of smart, passionate, and hardworking individuals. We are excited to expand the reach of our talents. As class president, it is my privilege to report to you on the post-high school plans of our seniors. Conestoga Valley High School's graduates will be pursuing degrees in higher education, technical education, specialized fields, and the medical fields. They will be entering the military services and pursuing unique training and certificate programs. Others will be starting their working careers in a variety of employment areas. Still, others are undecided and continue to explore their options. The class of 2018 will be attending many different colleges and universities. Among them include Alvernia, Auburn, Bloomsburg, Drexel, Georgia Institute of Technology, Millersville, Penn State, Rochester Institute of Technology, Temple, Yale, McGill, that's in Canada, for those of you who don't know, and the Ohio State University. Many of our graduates will be entering technical and community colleges very soon. These include Harrisburg Area Community College, the Career and Technical Center, Lancaster School of Cosmetology, the Navy's Nuclear Power School, Reading College of Health and Sciences, York Technical Institute, and the PA College of Health and Sciences. The class of 2018 will be pursuing majors in a variety of fields. These include engineering, liberal arts, business and accounting, criminology, film scoring, political science, pre-med, communications and marketing, education, and even applied mathematics. Good luck to whoever you are. The class of 2018 is very proud of these graduates who have decided to serve their country in the United States Armed Forces. I will ask the following students to stand and be recognized as I announce their names and service branches. Yosef Ben Kazmi, United States Army Reserves. Please remain standing. Zachary Rule, United States Navy. And Deanne Toro, United States Navy. Sorry, I came down with a cold like yesterday. The class of 2018 is very proud to carry on Conestoga Valley High School's tradition of the class legacy gift. The class legacy is a gift the senior class leaves designed to improve the educational environment for future generations of Buckskins. The class of 2018 recognizes the need for increased safety at Conestoga Valley High School, and to that end, wishes to donate $3,000 toward the purchase of devices and related software that allow for more accurate and efficient tracking of people entering and exiting the building. This technology creates identification cards for guests and can be used quickly to swipe students in and out of the building. We hope that this money and technology is put towards the most modern and effective devices in order to keep our fellow students safe. In addition, the class of 2018 will be donating $1,200 towards the American Dream Scholarship awarded at Senior Awards Night. This scholarship is awarded to those who have overcome more than most and have faced much adversity. Our class knows a lot about this struggle and are glad to be able to recognize the American Dream Scholars of the near future. The class of 2018 has several thank yous to share this evening. First, we would like to thank all our teachers, elementary, middle school, and high school, who have worked with us in their classrooms, on field trips, and in numerous activities. We wish to thank the support staff, secretaries, classroom aides, custodians, and many more for their work at CV. We wish to also thank our coaches and advisors for helping us to pursue our special interest activities. The class extends a very special thank you to Mr. Hank Oxendine. Our class has been very successful, and he played a huge part in this success. Finally, we want to show our appreciation to everyone who played a role in this commencement ceremony. Mr. Schley and Mr. Schenk, who worked with our speakers. Thank you to Mrs. Elizabeth Carney for directing our music this evening. And a special note of thanks goes out to Mr. Matthew Brubaker, our graduation coordinator. You successfully coordinated 323 17 and 18-year-olds, and not many can say that. Thank you for your patience and expertise. And to my peers, thank you. Thank you for electing me to this position. It has truly been an honor serving you and the high school for these past 4 years. Thank you for the memories, no matter the experience. Anything we faced would have been worse without everyone else to experience it. All of you, in one way or another, have played a role in my and each other's high school careers. We have been through a lot together. We were lucky enough to be the last class to have known Mr. Pritchard, but we certainly aren't the last to know his legacy. We experienced the opening of campus through Open Campus, internships, and work experience. The administration put a lot of trust in our class, but we delivered. Of course we did. We're a pretty great class. Of course, we can't forget about a defining moment of our high school career. The fire. We all know the struggle of trying to converse in the fan-filled hallways, and we know about the occasional smoky stench, but like everything else, in the end, we deal with it. All these experiences, like them or not, have made us better individuals. They have helped prepare us for what is to come. One piece of advice, for whatever is to come, certainly some of it will be hard, trying, and maybe degrading. Remember that God doesn't put anything in our path that He doesn't think we can handle. One of the most important things we learned in high school is that we can trust on our friends to be there to lean on. Now, one of the many lessons we take from this great moment is the importance of perseverance. Our high school diplomas are signs that we started as freshmen, we finished as seniors, and we now take this credential with us as a foundation for future learning. Much of success is about perseverance. It's about meeting challenges, addressing and confronting them, keeping it together, and pressing on. Graduating from high school is a great milestone for us, one that brings much celebration and good feelings. For some of us, this day has even more special meaning. I want to take a moment to tell you about some examples of perseverance in our class, of carrying on as life demands in the face of adversity and challenges. This is Alyssa Matus. She's a member of the class of 2018 and distinguished herself in the classroom, in her musical and athletic careers, and in her service to the community. She's ready to pursue a degree in graphics communication at Lebanon Valley College. Tragically, Alyssa faced the sudden loss of her father, just 8 days ago. Stricken with a sudden diagnosis of stage 4 cancer a little over 6 weeks ago, Alyssa and her family have had to persevere through the end of her high school career as they cared and comforted her father. The strength her and her family have shown through this most difficult time is remarkable and inspirational to us all. A special commencement ceremony was conducted at Alyssa's home on Monday, May 21st, so Alyssa's father could be present for her graduation. Her father is most definitely with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Alyssa Matus. There is another member of the class of 2018 that is a great example of perseverance. This is Jessica Long. Jessica is an outstanding academic student at CVHS, and she plans to pursue a career in history at Delaware County Community College. Jessica has a natural love of social studies and could always be counted on to project a smile and positive attitude in the hallways at Conestoga Valley. Most people would never guess that within the last year, Jessica was diagnosed with a severe kidney condition and is currently undergoing dialysis on a daily basis. She needs a kidney transplant and continues to seek a donor. Jessica never complains, but she is most definitely a fighter and someone who is planning for a long and healthy life. I'm holding in my hand a card you will find in the lobby after the ceremony that provides information on how you can help support Jessica. Please help her by spreading the word. Ladies and gentlemen, Jessica Long. Don't leave these inspiring stories here tonight. Take them with you to your next school, job, or day of work. Take the values Alyssa and Jess learned the very hard way and put them into action today. Thank you.
Thank you, Jared, Anna, Nicole. Great words, inspiring words about believing in yourself and finding your voice in this world, and indeed perseverance. Alyssa and Jessica, you do truly inspire us, and our hope is this community will continue to encourage and inspire you. The class of 2018 has left their mark on CV for sure. They've experienced many unique opportunities and challenges. Yes, you heard about the fire, and that was an adverse situation, but they responded very well. High achievement in the classroom, civic responsibility, and passion for their interests and activities all characterize this year's class. They have achieved at extremely high levels and have been recognized with distinction in academics, community service, technical and trade expertise, athletics, and for demonstrating the highest character in citizenship. Over the past few weeks, many of our graduates were present at this year's senior ceremonies marking our graduates' accomplishments and achievements. Among them were the Senior Athletic Awards Night, Senior Awards Night, CTC Certificate and Awards Nights, they were last night, as well as our end of the year concerts, activity banquets, and senior recognitions. All told, seniors received literally hundreds of awards, scholarships, and recognitions this year. Please join me in a round of applause for all of our winners. For these reasons and more, as principal, I am very proud that Conestoga Valley High School was once again recognized for a bronze award in the U.S. News and World Report's ranking of America's top high schools. And also, if you know anything about niche.com, it's another ranking of schools. We were ranked fourth best school in Lancaster County. Seniors, your contributions helped those distinctions. Another round of applause, please. The The next portion of our program will include comments from our superintendent and school board, followed by the final awards for the class of 2018. At this time, I'd like to call on the superintendent of the Conestoga Valley School District, Dr. Dave Zolkowski, to come forward for his remarks to the class.
For those of you expecting Dr. Huskin, I'm sorry. I was thinking about it. Dr. Huskin has been superintendent as long as you've been alive. And what we've done here and what you've done here at CV is a testament to his work and the work that continues to go on. I'd like to talk to you today about family. You can pick your friends, but you can't pick your family. How many times have you heard that or even thought that? Especially when your brother or sister or even your goofy Uncle John embarrasses you at one time or another. Now that may be true, but there's also a cliche that says blood is thicker than water. That being said, when you truly need that annoying brother or sister or that goofy Uncle John, they will be there for you. As a military brat whose dad was in the Navy and as an Air Force vet, I've lived in 8 places before I graduated high school and 10 places since. My sisters live in Arizona, Texas, and North Carolina. So my immediate family is hundreds of miles away. What I lived and continue to live is another family truth. Friends are family. Your family continues to grow as you do. When you were young, your parents, aunts, uncles, and grandparents took care of your every need, from putting food in your belly to putting Band-Aids on your scraped knees. They taught you how to tie your shoes, how to ride a bike, and most terrifying, how to drive a car. And I'm speaking from experience, because from my office window, I see you leave campus every single day. Now, as you grew, those who care about you increased in number as well. How many of you have an Uncle Mike or an Aunt Barb, someone who's a family friend who you still call aunt or uncle? They're not blood relatives, but they're always there for you. Later, as you got older, your friends became more important to you. Your BFF became your sister. Your buddy became your brother from another mother. Your sports teams, musical ensembles, or clubs became your extended families. Whenever a life-changing challenge or celebration occurred, your family grew even more. Whether it was your faith family or even the larger CV family, the CV community has a well-earned reputation in that it comes together like a family. Now, graduates, I know this is your day, and you are being celebrated for accomplishing yet another of the many milestones in your life. The reason I talk so much about family is because they have helped you discover who you are and who you have yet to become. They helped you form your beliefs and ideals, your interests and goals, your characters, your confidence, your very essence. When you look in the mirror, it will be hard not to notice the influence of your family. And I'm not talking just your dad's eyes, your mom's smile. Your family is very proud of you today. Just look around in the audience, the many people that are here for you, and all those who will gather with you after this ceremony. So please indulge me. Graduates, please stand. I'd like you to give a standing ovation and thank those people that have made you who you are today. The great thing about family is that they're always going to be there for you. And the cool thing about them is that your family will continue to grow. As you enthusiastically embrace all that life has to offer, you will build more relationships. You'll invite others into your family, and in turn, will become part of theirs. You might not remember all the information you learned in your 13 years of school, but I am positive you will never forget the people who impacted your life, your ever-growing family. So if you believe, as I do, that friends are family, the old adage is partly false. You can pick your family. On behalf of your parents, brothers, sisters, immediate family, and even your ever-growing extended family. Congratulations to each of you, the amazing graduates of the class of 2018. It is my honor now to introduce our school board president, Mr. Merle Esch.
Good evening, everyone. I brought an object lesson for you tonight. That's kind of my shtick. So let me get this out for you. Can everyone see this? Can anyone see this? Okay, for those of you who can't see, which is probably most of you, this is a single kernel of corn. Now listen carefully. You don't need to remember me, but I want you to remember this corny talk. You see what I just did there? Corn? Corny? Never mind. Anyway, I want to talk to you a little bit about planting and harvesting. And we're in the middle of beautiful Lancaster County right here, so this illustration should make a lot of sense to us. So back to the corny stuff, this kernel. In the spring of the year, like right about now, the farmer goes out and he takes a seed like this, along with thousands of others just like it, puts it in the ground, and he waits. And he waits. And just as sure as the sun comes up every morning, soybean plants grow. Wait, no, that's not right. I'm just being corny. Somebody tells me what grows from this little seed. Corn. Of course, we all get that. So from this tiny kernel of corn, a tall corn stalk grows, and on that corn stalk grow ears of corn, and sometimes multiple ears, and each ear has, I don't know if I want to make a mess up here, but, oh good, it has ears, or kernels on it. Each ear has hundreds of other kernels on it. And that, my friends, is the simple law of planting and harvesting. And just like the law of gravity, or Newton's third law of motion, which states for every action there is an equal and opposite. See, you can use what you learned in real life. Those laws are unchanging, and this law is unchanging too. The farmer doesn't put these corn seeds in the ground, these kernels, and expect soybeans to grow. That's ridiculous. No, he puts the corn seeds in the ground, and he expects corn. All right, I think that makes sense to all of us here, but I'm not here to give you an illustration in agricultural science. Let's take this illustration a step further. You see, this law is much more about just putting seeds in the ground. It's about seeds in your heart. You see, I can't plant jealousy in my life and expect to harvest contentment. Equally, I can't plant hatred and expect to harvest friendships. Either one of those thoughts is as ridiculous as planting corn and expecting soybeans. It's corny. Yet we do it all the time. We treat others with carelessness, and we wonder why we don't have lasting friendships. We selfishly think of ourselves and wonder why nobody cares. And we deliberately deceive others and wonder why people don't trust us. A verse from the New Testament reads, "Don't be misled. You cannot mock the justice of God. You will always harvest what you plant." Now the good news, since we can't get around this law, tonight I challenge you to harness its power, because this law also works for the good. If you plant friendship, you will harvest positive relationships. If you plant truth and honesty, You will harvest integrity and trust. And if you plant a concern for others, you will harvest a community of friends who will strengthen and enhance your life. And just like this little kernel, many times what you plant comes back to you in a harvest that is exponentially larger than the seed that you planted. So, off you go to the rest of your lives. Remember this corny talk. Be purposeful about the things that you plant and the things that you want to harvest. It's in your power to do this, so make the most of your opportunities. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but rather be an example to everyone in what you say, in the way you live, in your love, in your faith, and your purity. So on behalf of the Conestoga Valley School Board, I congratulate you, and I wish you the very best. I will turn it over to Dr. Zukowski now for the presentation of the Real Medal of Honor.
This is a great tradition. The Real Medal of Honor is given for outstanding service, leadership, and support to the CV community. And each year it is given here at graduation. The community member who is being recognized for making a positive difference is Mr. Tom Hillen. There's also two students nominated by the faculty to receive the Real Medal of Honor. The first person is Ms. Nicole Redig. And the second person, Mr. Jared Steed. Congratulations once again. It's my pleasure now to introduce Ms. Carrie Mulvihill, CVEA President.
Hello everyone, my name is Carrie Mulvihill and I teach at our middle school. My main purpose for being here tonight is to award three amazing 2018 graduates with scholarships. But if you know me, you know I'm a storyteller at heart, and every year at this time, I try to relate graduation to a story. So here I go. One of my favorite movies is The Wizard of Oz. And it just so happens that this movie and life have many similarities. Throughout our lives, but especially at a time like graduation, we all have a destination or goal in mind. Sometimes, like Dorothy, goals are set to change circumstances that displease us. Other times, goals are made because we seek wholeness, inner peace, and being the best version of ourselves, much like the Scarecrow, the Tin Man, and the Lion. Goals are what keep us moving along our yellow brick roads. As we navigate our bricks, we cannot be naive enough to think it will all be poppies and roses. We will most certainly encounter our fair share of strange characters, along with obstacles, fears, and even posers who try to outsmart us. But wisdom, heart, and courage will always prevail. And who could forget Dorothy's ultimate realization, the idea that there is no place like home. And although the grass may seem greener in an emerald city, and somewhere over the rainbow can be a nice place to visit, we must remain grounded and grateful for all that we have right here in front of us. CV graduates, home for you these last 12 or so years has been the Conestoga Valley School District. Tonight, we honor the contributions that you've made to your school and yourselves. Earlier, I mentioned that I teach at the middle school, but also, in addition, I am the president of the Conestoga Valley Education Association, or more commonly known as our local teachers union. So on this special night, I represent all those wonderful teachers who have influenced your lives over the last 12 years. As you made your way through the classrooms and hallways of our CV schools, you have made connections and memories with teachers that have shaped a piece of who you are and that will hopefully help guide you throughout the rest of your lives. The scholarship I present is an investment that your teachers, the Conestoga Valley Education Association, make in the future. This scholarship is funded solely by the voluntary contributions of the educators of the Conestoga Valley School District. So congratulations on your success that we celebrate tonight, and good luck to all of you as you continue your journey down your own yellow brick roads. Tonight, your teachers, our association, will be awarding a total of $12,000 in scholarships. And each of our recipients will receive a $4,000 scholarship award. So, without further ado, I'd like to call these award winners to the stage. And they are Palak Patel, Nicole Reddig, and Madeline Weaver. Please come forward. Congratulations. Great to see you all. Thank you all. And now I'd like to welcome Mr. Thornton back to the stage.
Thank you so much, Ms. Mulvihill, and the generosity of our association on those scholarships. It is now my pleasure to introduce the top 10% of the class of 2018. This is a tradition that we have had here at CV for a very long time. It represents the top academic achievers as represented by their overall weighted GPA. These students are winners of the President's Education Award. I have a proclamation here from the White House. Each student will receive this. Congratulations on receiving the 2018 President's Education Award. Mrs. Trump and I are proud to join your family, friends, and teachers in celebrating this outstanding achievement. Through hard work and perseverance in the classroom, you have earned this great honor and set your path toward an even brighter future. We commend you on this accomplishment, and we send our best wishes for continued success as you further your education and pursue your dreams. President Donald Trump. When I call the student's name, please stand and remain standing and hold your applause until we call all students. These students also received a certificate, and they will be wearing the gold tassel. They have a gold tassel along with their regular tassel. First student, Lindsay Allshaus, Tegan Jabri Beitzel, Serena Blessing, Caitlin Carter, Emily Clapper, Julianne Cox, Anna Cutler, Kiara Diaz Gutierrez, Teodora Dillman, David Formica, Catherine Fowler, Sarah Fry, Chloe Kaufman, Nicholas Kramer, Carter Lamb, Justin Min Lee, Andrew Lin, Alyssa Matus, Elizabeth McCombs, Benjamin McLean, Savannah Mead, Ian Miller, Caroline Nava, Palak Patel, Nicholas Pham, Eliana Prisuera, Nicole Reddick, Teresa Rogers, Callie Rumba, Audrey Salmons, Annie Shan, Jared Steed, Alexia Trott, Madeline Weaver, and Lauren Yoder. Ladies and gentlemen, the top 10% of the class of 2018. Please be seated. I'd like to call up now our assistant principals, Ms. Shalena Coleman and Dr. Matthew Fox, for the awarding of the salutatorian and valedictorian.
Congratulations to the entire class of 2018. I get the pleasure this evening of honoring this year's salutatorian, and that is Miss Nicole Redding. And Dr. Fox to present our valedictorian.
Good evening. Once again, seniors, congratulations on this great night. As Ms. Coleman said, I get to announce this year's valedictorian. The valedictorian of class of 2018, Catherine Fowler.
Moments so dear, 525,000 25,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles, in laughter, in strife. In 525,600 minutes. How do you measure?
How about another big hand for our senior choral singers? All right, ladies and gentlemen, members of the Conestoga Valley School Board and Dr. Zukoski as principal, I attest that the candidates assembled here tonight making up the Conestoga Valley High School class of 2018 have met all the requirements for graduation from high school as set by the state of Pennsylvania and the Conestoga Valley School District and are now eligible to receive their high school diploma and with it all the rights and privileges intrinsic to this degree. We are now ready for the presentation of diplomas, and conferring diplomas this evening are Mr. Merle Esch, President of the Conestoga Valley Board of Directors, and Dr. Zukoski. assisting us on stage tonight, junior officers, Michael Janvren and Rebecca Sampson. They've done a lot of work here. You can give them a round of applause too. They're working hard. Our first graduate, Abigail Forney. Michael Florio. April Aki. Eric Eddy. Nathan Schell. Amy Gonzalez. Jagger Blau. Kyra Leonard. Kirsten Harnish. Victoria Glick. Dallas Arroyo. Matthew Bandy. Alyssa Walton. Bethany Gajewski. Danny Beecher. Kyle Ansel. Nathan Benjamin Leadham. Michael Snavely. Brandon Bear. Ryan Graham. Melissa Marie Weeder. Tegan Jabri Beitzel. Kylie Gant. Wilson Chang. Christone Castillo. Chancellor Boyd. Davon Christian. Darian Calderon. Brittany Yost. Eric Taggart. Logan Andrew. Destiny Danz. Madison Feaser. Julia Brenner. Jacob Fazekas. Justin Martin. Kylie Joy Buckley. Tanner Schwilk. Eduardo Cruz. Jari Diaz. Jolito E. Ortiz Jr. Jose Claudio Morales. Ethan Grubb. Jeremy Good. Griffin Ford. Catherine Rachel Fowler. Anthony Duong. To Ha. Faith Cover. Jordan Huertes. Jason Keys. Kyle Mamula. Teal Johnson. Francis Ortiz Cassiano. Deanne Toro. Jessica Mercedes Long. Michael Lefevre. Adelie Broadbent. Serena Blessing. Seth Martin. Kenny Jackson. Graham King. Samuel Lorenz. Avalia Bermudez. Kyle Johnson. Logan McFalls. Paige Miller. Yosef Ben Cosmi. Dominic McQuelly. Xavier Lopez. Ethan Midgley. Madison Lutchkis. Eliza Medina. Nigeia Milburn. Tyler Oakley. Brady Metzler. Destiny Mendez. Arence Menard. Okay, want to make sure we can hear all our names and stay on our pacing, please. Joshua Moore. Andrea Watkins. Alyssa Spade. Dylan Bayless. Ali DeJesus. Joshua Dawson. Rebecca Fasarakis. Cameron Souter. Isabel Burke. L'Oreal Booth. Jonathan Bailey. Faith Burney. Jonathan Blake. Nathaniel Blake. Cheng Mua. Nathan Hershey. Delani Oak. Mary Millark. John Hand. Paula Medina Quiones. Chanel Allen. Luis Perez. Leanne Ray Doutrick. Michael Clow. Austin Monroe. Hannah Coonan. Logan Monroe. Nadia Swinton. Michaela Everett. Alvario Martinez. Nicholas Nargang. Michael Croy. Madison Bradis. Ayushi Patel. Abner Martinez. Victor Alexi. Netani Orta. Danita Orta. Jacob Dissinger. Ronald Switek. Devante Gray. Gabriel Chiquito. Priscilla Francois. Alanis Velasquez Rivera. Lindsay Allshouse. Thomas Durr. Nini Kim. Mario Abdel Messi. Roytez Longino. Samantha Ortiz. Caleb Hoover. Austin High. Madison Hanwerger. Riley Garrity. Chad Hudson. Amy Haldeman. Brooke Bingham. Andrew Lynn. Riley Klein. Sebastian Solbrig. Michael Harrison. Brett Martin. Allison Martine. Rachel Adela Enriquez. Allison Lumsden. Jacob Lemke. Alyssa Matus. Delaney G. Dugan. Carter Benjamin Lamb. And finishing out our first half of graduates, Theodora Caroline Dillman. We'll get switched around here quickly. It is a long-standing tradition at CV that board members who have graduating seniors will present their senior with their diploma. Tonight we have three such board members, and the first is Mrs. Julia Reed, who will present to her son, Jacob Reed. Kat Raup. Zachary David Rule. Kaylee Raglan. Kyle Lenahan. Robert Wilson Ayers Potter. Alexis Palmer. Natalie Martin. Michael Rush. Megan Euler. Andrew Perozic. Matt Lemonowski. Courtney Wiley. Savannah Generella. Samantha Peters. Shivan Patel. Andrew Rosso. Brennan Glick. Francesco Del Castillo. Teresa Rogers. Ben Yishmael Rivera. Darson Patel. Kelsey Buckwalder. Trent Ryder. Sarah Fry. Emily Reif. Alyssa Sky Walker. Maddie Severin. Ben Rudder. Ethan Daigle. Kaya Rupert. Stephanie Burkholder. Caitlin Carter. Daniel Scala. Emily Clapper. Callie Rumba. And our second board member presenting this evening is Mr. John Smucker. He will be presenting to his daughter, Corinne Smucker. Addison Diener. Andy Wong. Victoria Good. Ali Fadil. Leslie Nicole Schmerfeld. Julianne Cox. Grace Sensenig. David Formica. Annie Shand. Kyle Lapp. Alexis Spencer. Megan Stone. Jonathan Garber. Ingrid Grove. Chris Schoenberger. Pujan Shaw. Matthew Rondinella. Kiara Diaz Gutierrez. Ben Smith. Alexia Trott. Alex Markley. Emily Schaefer. Brianna Jennings. Jose Ortiz. Carla Santiago. Patrick Harvey. Braxton Lucas. Allison Stoltzfus. Mitchell Schiffer. Elizabeth McCombs. Audrey Salmons. Dylan Ulishny. Savannah Walton. Julian Eliud, I'm sorry, Julian. Julian Eliud Tarache. Robert Deem. Anna Solenberger. Elena Prizuera. Ben McLean. Nicole Reddick. Brianna Long. Cameron Tuno. Victoria Teleguz. Joseph Victoria. Madeline Weaver. Chloe Kaufman. Tyler Wolf. Lauren Yoder. Nicholas Pham. Palak Patel. Elijah Miller. Brandon Mendez. Clayton Byers. Aubrey Smith. Natalie Burkholder. Noel Veach. Owen Miller. Emma Wyrick. Sue Ndonga. Tobichi Thomas. Aaron Dungsori. Gabe Obiama. Chastity Whitley. Gio Lopez. Caitlin Rose Wendling. Josiah James Foster. Madison Velez. Abe Elegrab. Alyssa Gonzalez. Sierra Varela Keen. Carly Scott Monger. Nicholas Kramer. Abby Zamores Herr. Caitlin Crimes. Adriana Molina. Zion Morales. Ellie Micus. Caroline Nava. James Ripson. Ian Miller. And our final board member parent this evening to present their diploma to their daughter is Mrs. Dana Mead to Savannah Mead. Justin Min Lee. Nolan Kachi. Faris Kasim. Rora Emanuel. Luisa Maria Gonzalez Mancalino. Kaylee Aviles. Andrea Gribble. Clark Lumsden. Mitchell Miller. Mateo Sino. Caleb Valenga. Dakota Shirt. Avery Barton. Jose Barbon Linares. Zach Lehman. Anna Cutler. And the following are the officers for the class of 2018. Secretary Melissa Chang. Treasurer Jacqueline Thornton. Vice President Mezgana Yilma. And the president of the class of 2018, Jared Steed. All right, we'll clear the stage here for the big moment. Jared, I'd ask you to do the honors. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2018 graduates of Conestoga Valley High School.
Mike, you want your water?